Hey, what's up? It's Blake, and in this video, we're going over the top Dollar Tree Christmas products for 2020.
Okay, this is kind of embarrassing. I did not film the correct intro. What you need to know is I'm giving away Dollar Tree gift cards at the end of this video, so watch the whole video.
So let me explain how I selected these items. I didn't just go into a Dollar Tree and randomly pick Christmas stuff. Instead, I methodically sifted through the websites, social media accounts, YouTube channels of 40 Dollar Tree home decor influencers. They all had a lot of different suggestions, but I found about 10 items that they all consistently thought were going to be really popular things to buy, or in our case, sell this holiday season. A side note, if you're just watching this and you want to see the good deals, this video is perfectly fine for you too. You don't have to watch these with the sole intent of reselling. What I'm doing, my main goal here, is to identify undervalued things. You can use those for resale, or you can just save money. Either is good, in my humble opinion.
First things first, we have a green and red sequin Santa Claus hat. Again, everything in this video costs $1. It's the Dollar Tree. Everything costs $1 there. This is, I'd say, the second best item out of the whole batch. The last item is really, really, really good, so stay tuned for that. But this item, I think that I will sell the most of these. There is a red velvet Santa Claus hat you're going to see in a second, but this one, because it has the sequins, anytime you can have more accessories, I think you're going to do better in sales. You could also bundle this in packs of five. It's very light. You can put it in a poly mailer and just ship it out. I think this is the ideal type of item to resell, not only because of the imminent demand we're going to see in November and December, but also because it's so easy to ship and you're not going to have returns. And now we come to the red velvet Santa Claus hat. This is not nearly as cool as the sequin hat. Clearly, there's no sparkles on it. Why would I ever wear it? Just kidding. Some people do still want this. Maybe the sequins are a bit too shimmery, a bit too eye-catching. They want a more modest cranium. One thing I would note about these, if you are selling them, they are a bit small. So I would measure the diameter of the hat and put that in the listing, just so you're guarded against any returns from big fat heads like me. When I bought this one, I did not intend to have three instances of headgear. I thought it was like a dog collar. Nope, it's a reindeer antler headband with three little brass bells on it. Again, $1. Again, very easy to ship. You could even consider bundling all three hats together because they weigh less than 8 ounces. You're only going to pay $3 and, you know, 9 cents. Pop it in a poly mailer, ship them out, and I would estimate you can charge probably $5 a piece. So you're making $15 off of your, including shipping, about $6.25 investment. Three very similar products coming up soon. They are pot holder and oven mitt sets. So what you see on the screen right now, I paid $2 for. It's one oven mitt and two pot holders. There are three designs of two pot holders and one oven mitt. So what you can do is sell this set individually for about $10, or you can lot them up with three designs and sell that for closer to $25. The profit margin's a bit better on the bulk lot, but you're going to sell less of them, so plan accordingly. The next item is also a bundled set. I bought these two items separately. It's ornament filler and a clear bulb ornament. I'm calling this the DIY ornament bulb. I paid $2 for this, and you can sell this set for up to $10. If you add some glue in there, if you maybe put in 4 or 5 of these bulbs, then you might make a lot more money. Really, this is up to you. I think that this listing has the most potential for upward growth. I'm not totally convinced on this item, but time and time again, I saw all these Dollar Tree influencers saying gnomes are hot this year. Make sure you get gnomes. There's gnomes everywhere. I don't claim to be an expert on gnomes, but if enough people are talking about gnomes, then yes, I'm going to try and sell one. This is a gnome ornament. $1. I don't see any of these selling right now because they're new this year, but I would predict it goes for between $7 and $15. These stirring spoons from Palmer are a great example of an item you should definitely sell on eBay and not Amazon. For those of you who don't know, eBay is much more generous to sellers who understand how to use keywords correctly. On Amazon, the brand matters more, the sales rank matters more, but on eBay, if someone wants chocolate stirring spoons and you have chocolate stirring spoons, it doesn't matter if they're Godiva, it doesn't matter if they're Palmer. It matters if you have them and if your picture is good and the price is agreeable. Amazon, not so much, but I see a lot of these selling on eBay this winter. One of the best things about seasonal decor is it's so easy to lot up. This is garland, simple, it's like 15 feet. You can see it right there on the label. But how many things can you add garland to and charge an extra $5 for? What comes to my mind is the Christmas trees we're going to see pretty soon, but almost anything Christmas themed can reasonably be lotted up with garland. And even though you only paid a dollar, I've seen $5 increases when these accessories are added. Similar to the DIY ornament, bulbs are DIY mason jar ornaments. These are a little bit heavier. They weigh 1.5 ounces a piece as opposed to the 0.8 ounces per bulb. So if you're lotting these up, plan accordingly. That means for a pound in an 8-ounce box, you can only have 5 of these. 5 times 1.5 plus 8 ounces for a standard box puts you at 15.5 ounces, and that is just below the 1-pound limit.
One quick tip about shipping. So for most of the items, the hats, the soft things, the gnomes, I'll be putting them in a poly mailer. This is a plastic mailer, very thin. But for something like a Santa Claus hat, what's it gonna do? It's cloth.
And now to our final two items, which happen to be the same item, just in different colors. These are 2-foot Christmas trees. This one's in green. The other one you're gonna see in a second is iridescent. At least that's the word they keep using on the blogs. I looked at it, it looks like white to me. I don't see iridescent, but iridescent is the keyword, so when you're listing it, I would encourage prodigious use. Unfortunately, there are no iridescent garland strands at the Dollar Tree, so if you're trying to beef out your tabletop Christmas tree listing with some garland, you're only going to be limited to the green ones, but I still think that this is going to be a really good seller this year.
That's the video, folks. Thank you for watching, and remember, as always, thumbs up, subscribe, and leave a comment below. Oh, geez, the Dollar Tree gift cards. I almost forgot. So what I'm doing is giving away two $25 Dollar Tree gift cards. I spent about that much on my items, so I said, you know what, why not give someone else that opportunity? We're doing two giveaways, and what I did is about 3/4 through this video, I put some text on the screen. Pretty sneaky, right? I want you to answer that question, and who gets the gift cards? Two people. The best answer and the worst answer. So have some fun. Comment with whatever it is, and I will pick who I think most deserves it and least deserves it, because I like to have fun. And what's more fun than randomly giving away gift cards to the Dollar Tree? Anyways, that's the real end of the video. See you guys next time. And remember, every Wednesday at noon Eastern time, I am going live answering everyone's questions for my free business mentorship hour. Every Wednesday on my YouTube channel, I want you guys to make money. I really do. Bye.